When I started to learn more about our Bachelor of Commerce degree with information on page 52, I started to think I may have been a little underqualified for that position. I could have approached the students in our accounting major to help me with all that number crunching. It was a $1.2 million operating budget. While dealing with all of those staff issues, I could have approached the students in our leadership and organizational management major on page 54, which is our version of human resources management. Now, we like to say when you graduate with a commerce degree from Guelph, you essentially graduate with two degrees, one in your particular major, but you also take core business courses. So even if your major is in public management, studying the relationship between government and business, you're still taking courses in accounting, human resources, marketing, consumer behavior, and trends. So it really rounds out your education and prepares you to be a leader in whichever industry you go into. The final degree program I'll let you know about is our Bachelor of Landscape Architecture program. I totally lied there. There's one more after this. So Bachelor of Landscape Architecture is on page 38. And landscape architects have some of the most fun jobs in the world. They get to work where others only get to play. Imagine your workplace being a playground, Canada's Wonderland, or even university campuses. Landscape architects design these spaces to fit place to fit people and the demands of foot traffic for these spaces, including waterfront Toronto or even urban gardening systems. If you are interested in landscape architecture, pay special attention to our unique admission requirements down on the bottom of page 38, including the submission of a background information form. This is required for admission purposes, so make sure if you are interested, to start that. And now the final degree program I'll let you know. That is our Bachelor of Arts and Sciences with information on page 50. And in our Bachelor of Arts and Sciences program, you actually select two minors, not a major, one from the arts and one from the sciences. Now my friend Billy and I were 13 when CSI first appeared. And maybe I just aged myself horribly there, but ever since then, he wanted to become the next Bill Grissom from the original CSI. When he went to university to study arts and sciences in Guelph, he minored in chemistry from the science stream and criminal justice and public policy from the art stream. And with this unique specialization combination in mind, he's since been employed by a crime lab in downtown Ottawa. Another key element of the arts and sciences program are the core arts and science courses called ASCII courses that serve to bridge the gap between science and society. And even better, you can always create your own. Lauren Wallace was a third-year student, and after her third year, she went to Mount Kilimanjaro to do the climb in Tanzania, Africa. And when she came back, she created her own arts and science course, where she studied the physical and human science behind climbing and the impact it has on our body, as well as the impact tourism has had on the area around Mount Kilimanjaro as the arts promotion. This is just one example of how you really can take your University of Guelph degree anywhere around the world. And if you look at page 21, you can see a few lists of where to go exactly. See, at Guelph, we aren't afraid to color outside of the lines or travel outside of our borders. So take a semester abroad, living in India or Guatemala with 20 other Guelph students and Guelph faculty member, witnessing firsthand in a single moment how beautiful and harsh this world can truly be. In our exchange programs, the more traditional route is where we actually just trade students with another university around the world. So feel free to pick up some German while going to school there, hit the beaches of Fiji in between classes, or trace the steps of the Lord of the Rings set while studying in New Zealand. If you'd rather be a true adventurer and forge your own path, then you can use our letter of permission program to study at just about any university around the world. So that does it for our academic degree programs. Any questions about what to study? Anything that piqued your interest so far? No? Alright, there's a bit more to come. I was always told to live is to learn, and maybe that's why I learned some of my greatest lessons while living in Guelph's residences for 4 years. If we take a look at page 6 instead, we'll start learning more about residences. Now, as I said, I lived in residence for 4 years, and on page 7, you see an aerial shot of the entire campus. In my first 3 years, I lived in East Residences, which are apartment style with access to full kitchens. While there, I picked up some French and even some tips on how to live a more green lifestyle while visiting friends in the Maison Française and Eagle House, two of our four living learning centers. In my fourth and final year, I lived in North Residences, and with the help of an academic cluster, which is where you live in the same section as students in the same program as yourself, I finally packed the beans. And of course, there's South Residences as well, one of the largest housing complexes in Canada, holding close to 2,000 students there. It has the highest number of single rooms and the lowest ratio of students to washrooms. So if you're looking for a bit more privacy, South Residences might be just for you. On the many different types of communities that you can live in Residences. Residence is guaranteed for all first-year students so long as you meet the deposit and application deadline date of June 3rd, so you might want to circular start that one. Now, as I said, I was a member of Interhall Council, the resident student government for every year I lived in Residence, and from time management to professionalism to simply making an amazing group of friends, Residence has changed me by challenging me and helped shape what I've become today. I left Residence with a lengthy list of invaluable life lessons, and I also left Residence with a much-needed extra 15 pounds, courtesy of our hospitality services and meal plans on pages 10 and 11. Now, I was desperate to add on a few extra pounds, but if you're very health-conscious, which is entirely understandable as well, don't worry, wealth has you covered. We've been ranked number one for on-campus food services for the past 8 years now across the country, and it comes as no surprise to me. I can start my day off with a health kick, eating some fresh local fruit, or more often, I can start my day off with a thick, fresh Belgian waffle, top off with that fresh local fruit, drizzled with real maple syrup, and top off with a spoonful of whipped cream. Now, in my household, we ate dinner together every night, so I was pleased to hear that me and my new family from Residence had 17 different dining facilities to choose from. So whether we wanted some wings while watching the Leafs lose another game on the big screen, or we wanted some comfort foods and familiar names like Subway or Pizza Pizza or even Casey's delivered straight to our residence room door, we always had choice. Your meal plans go on your student card and operate like a debit system. You can see there are 5 different kinds, from minimum all the way to party varsity, depending on your appetite size. So you can eat what you want, when you want, where you want, all with a simple swipe of your student card. Now another way to help keep those 15 pounds off is with our athletics department. And if you look at pages 16 and 17, you'll see a few of the ways that wealth can have you up, moving around, and having fun. You can join an intramural team playing some traditional sports like indoor or outdoor soccer, volleyball, ice hockey once or twice a week, or you can try some non-traditional sports like inner tube water polo or underwater hockey. Underwater hockey is the most exhausting thing ever. You're just holding your breath and going up and down all the time, but a great workout lung capacity increase. Or you can join fitness classes. We offer several different fitness classes from yoga, spinning, Pilates, to certification courses like first aid, CPR, and scuba diving. And we also have varsity athletics as well, so if you are interested in varsity sports, come chat with me afterwards and I can give you some coach contact information. Or you can visit griffins.ca, Griffins is our team mascot name, and fill out the varsity athlete recruitment form there. Now if you're more comfortable, outside of the gym as I was, but you're still looking to get involved, page 17 has just a few examples of the over 150 different clubs operating on campus. So whether you're looking for some like-minded students to share a worship session with, or you want to try your hand at journalism, volunteering for the Ontario, so newspaper, or you want to try something new like skydiving at the Outdoor Adventures Club, the possibilities really are endless. The City of Guelph, with information on pages 24 and 25, also offer endless opportunities for shopping, dining, and experiences. When my friends and I were dancing downtown, listening to some live music, or just lazily wandering around some of the green spaces around the city, we'd head to the Sleeman Center, home of the OHL's Guelph Storm, former home of Drew Doughty, who's since become a national hero since helping lead our men's team to Olympic gold at the 2010 Vancouver Games. Now, for the past 3.5 years now, my job has been touring Ontario and across the country, talking to students like yourselves who are interested about coming to the University of Guelph. And I've had a pretty rewarding job, because the 5 years that I spent at the University of Guelph were some of the most rewarding, fun, challenging, but awesome times that I've had in my life. And so when I get to visit students and I get to share these stories, I'm basically reliving some of the best years of my life. In December, my contract comes to a close and I move on. I don't know what's next, but I know that I'm well prepared for whatever it is, because of my University of Guelph degree, and because of the lessons I learned there. And no matter what, I always have a soft place to fall. That was my mother's one piece of advice when I was growing up to university. No matter where you go or what you do, always have a soft place to fall. And the friends that I met there, professors and faculty that changed my outlook on life, and the staff that I've made as friends ever since I started working there, have ensured that I always have a soft place to fall. And I hope that no matter where you go or what you do, you also have a soft place to fall. So thank you for your time and attention. I'll gladly hang around for any extra questions. I see we have about 10 minutes, so group questions or one-on-one. And if you have completed the card towards the back of the book, please hand that in on the way out. Otherwise, thank you very much. Questions? All right, thanks a lot.